In this video, we'll look at how to run Nginx on Kubernetes. Specifically, we're going to use Nginx as a Kubernetes ingress controller. In this video, we'll be using Google Kubernetes Engine for our Kubernetes cluster, but you should be able to follow along if you're using other Kubernetes providers. Our installation approach will be based on the Nginx ingress helm chart. After that's installed, we'll set up test resources with the kubectl command and code that's shared in the description of this video. With what we're trying to achieve now established, let's jump into the Google Cloud Console and set up a Kubernetes cluster for the demonstration. After that, we use the Google Cloud Shell IDE to install our Nginx ingress controller and run kubectl commands. So in the console, the first thing we need to do is go to the Kubernetes engine page. Since this is a brand new project, it's going to request that we enable the API. With that API now enabled, let's create our cluster. We're going to change very little here and essentially proceed with the default configuration. The main thing I'd like to change here is the node count for our default node pool. In a production configuration, you may want more nodes for your workloads or an auto-scaling setup. However, this will work for us for now. Note that the cost is about $101 if we run this for a full month. In this demonstration, we'll only keep the cluster running for about an hour or so, and then we'll fully delete it afterwards. So we'll be charged somewhere in the ballpark of 20 cents. With that in mind, let's go ahead and proceed. Okay. With that cluster now created, let's use the Google Cloud Shell to install both the Nginx ingress controller and our example resources. As a prerequisite, we need to authenticate with the cluster that we just created. One of the benefits of using this cloud shell is that we get automatic authentication within our project. It's also going to provide us CLIs out of the box, like the Helm CLI and the kubectl CLI. We want to get credentials for this cluster one, and we'll use a command of this format. If we run a get namespace command, that will check to make sure we're authenticated. Let's next add our Helm repo. Now, before we run the Helm install, let's go ahead and take a quick peek at the documentation. This is an open source project, and we can find the code in the Kubernetes organization on GitHub. Specifically, with this Ingress Nginx repo, we can go to the charts directory and then Ingress Nginx to see the reference commands for the Helm repository and release. Importantly, you should be aware of the Helm values that you can set in order to customize the Nginx Ingress controller installation. We won't need that customization and can use the defaults for this demo. However, if, for example, you wanted to change the name of the Ingress class, you could do that with these values. If you want to see the default values in a different format, you can click on the values.yaml here, and you'll see those defaults. For example, here's that Ingress class name specification. Back to our Cloud Shell, we could set custom values if we needed to using the set command. There are also ways to provide larger sets of values using a custom values.yaml file. Anyway, let's proceed with the default installation. Great, that all looks good. So we're now going to set up those resources that we alluded to earlier. We'll set up an Ingress, which will use the new Ingress class, a service, and a deployment. The flow of traffic will basically look like this. The Ingress exposes an endpoint and is backed by a service. The service, in turn, is backed by our deployment workload. I'll show the resources in the console here, but remember that this code is available on GitHub. A link is in the description of this video, so you don't need to copy these configurations manually. So here's our Ingress. We need to specify that we're going to use our new Nginx Ingress class, which is not the default Ingress class for this Kubernetes cluster. We're specifying HTTP backends and using an open source application called PGWeb as an example. The PGWeb service is defined here. The service will be exposed on port 80, but actually served on port 8081. So we're doing a bit of port mapping here. As far as the deployment workload, this is a single instance of the PGWeb application container. If you're following along, you just need to change this host specification here to a domain that you control. If you want to access the application on just an IP, remove the host configuration line. All right, let's go ahead and apply these resources with the kubectl command. The important resource to watch is this Ingress here. What we want is for a public IP to show up. To see the configuration and resource creation events, we can use a describe command. So we now have an address, which is good. Let's copy that address and point our domain to it. In our case, that domain will be pgweb.notomatic.io. You could do this in any DNS provider, but I'm going to go ahead and do it in Google Cloud DNS. The DNS zone is actually in a different project, so I'm going to switch to that project briefly and set up the record. If you choose to access the ingress by IP only, there's no need to configure any DNS records. Okay, let's go ahead and check our pod to make sure that's running. Great, PGWeb is running as well as our Nginx ingress controller. It may take a couple of minutes to be ready, but if we open a new tab and go to that domain, we should eventually see our PGWeb console open up here. Since this networking is powered by Nginx, we have quite a lot of configurability. Let's introduce how we can use annotations to refine the networking. So let's actually open up the editor for this. And we'll add annotations here. For example, if we wanted to enable cores, or perhaps configure the proxy body size, we could do that here. And now if I save and reapply that ingress resource, we're going to have an updated ingress. If we go back to the GitHub repository, then to the associated documentation, and then to the annotation section of the user guide, we'll see the wide range of networking options available for our ingress resources. For example, we could very easily add an SSL certificate for HTTPS using the same annotations approach. More or less, anything that you can do with standard Nginx, you can do here with the Nginx ingress resources. So, to recap, we executed a two-step process for setting up Nginx-based networking on Google Kubernetes Engine. First, we added the Helm repo for the Nginx ingress controller and ran a Helm install to get it running on our cluster. Second, we run a kubectl command to create an ingress, a service, and a deployment. While there might be small tweaks required, these steps should be very similar on other Kubernetes providers. Let's wrap up by showcasing how to clean up these resources. So first, we run a delete command to remove the Kubernetes application resources. Next, we can run a Helm uninstall to uninstall the Nginx ingress controller. If you set up a DNS record, let's remove that as well. Lastly, we can delete the Kubernetes cluster. This final cleanup is really important to make sure that you're not surprised by any Google Cloud charges. Now that we have a clean slate again, I think it's a good time to wrap this video. We hope this demonstration was helpful, and thank you for watching.